Hey there, HBI Guys Model Workshop back with another kit review for you. This is AMT's 1940 Willis Coupe in 1/25th scale. And because they have the Three Stooges license, they are using the heck out of it, and I love it. This is called Curly's Gasser. Double entendre? I guess so. Means one, means the other. Of course, you're all familiar with the earlier release of their sedan delivery in the Three Stooges seam, and I love that kit. And this is another one, so when I saw this available, I had to pick it up. I got this online from Tower Hobbies for less than $25, and it seems like a nice enough kit, so let's start taking a look inside the box. First thing you'll know, it's got the standard AMT, very blank, basic manual. I guarantee this 40 Willis has been out before. It's just been re-released with the Curly's Gasser theme, and that's just fine with me. It doesn't make a specific reference to what kind of V8 is under the hood. The only thing it actually names is a GMC 671 blower in the manual. So you can assemble that to be a mean little gasser on the strip. You can see we've got the body, we've got the engine, and they have you start assembling it. There's not many steps whatsoever to building this kit. And then, of course, at the end, you will have a hood that will open up and tilt forward, and it will actually lock into place with the hinge bars and hinge pins, a small paint guide, and then an advertisement for that sweet 40 delivery, which I also own. Now, what's important about this re-release? The decal sheet. That's the big difference, okay? These gorgeous, gorgeous decals that are all Three Stooges themed. You can see they've got spread out on the right there. All kinds of cool decals, and they got that nice swirl. They've got your competitor decals, lots of sponsor decals as well. You don't have to build it as the Curly's Gasser, but then you might as well buy a different version of it, unless you wanted the sponsor decals, because they're very nice. But the color is great. And the decal sheet looks like it's a winner. I really like that. I really like that Curly's Gasser theme. Now, what else is in the box? Well, we got some chrome. We got three trees of chrome, two little ones, one big one. The chrome looks to be done pretty nice. You can see on this tree we've got one set of wheels, and you get two different sets. We've got carburation, headers, belt shield, oil pan, valve cover gaskets, more of those wheels. We've got that GMC 671 blower, as they list it as. The grill, which could definitely use a wash, so you could actually individually see it. I don't think you want to drill that out. Steering wheel. Alright. And then we've got these nice wheels. Now, these are my favorite of the two. And these are definitely nicely done. See, front and rear, fat and skinny. The rest of the kit is molded in this lovely shade of purple. Yep, purple.
Purple.
So if you're building a Grape Ape edition, you are set. We've got, of course, the engine and transmission halves, springs, radiator hoses. This part here and this part here are your blower scoop halves, and a firewall. On this tree here, we've got seats, nice looking bucket seats, front springs, wheel backs, front suspension and steering. A lot of flash on that part, so be very careful with it. And what I'm assuming are inner fenders. Now, let me step to the other side of the camera, pull out some more plastic. We got more purple plastic. This is all in one parts bag. What do we got in this one? We've got the dashboard. No decals for the dash, gonna have to pick that one out. And she's only got two pedals. belts, heads, front suspension, wheelbacks, shocks. Also included in this kit are two pieces of metal rod for your axles, just to let you know. Got your lake pipes there, your side pipes, done in purple plastic though. We've got our interior bucket real small because a Willis was not a big vehicle. But it's done, you're just going to have to pick those parts out individually. You can see how that pan attaches and those large pins there. Should be easy to locate stuff. So the interior is done nice. No problem at all. And then you got your traction bars here. Molded open. That's nice. And no flash really to worry about on those. But I do like that they were molded open. Thank you, Round 2 and AMT. Now let's get over some more purple plastic. Whoa, did you see that? He wanted to be on camera so bad he jumped into the frame before I even brought him over. We've got our front clip here, which will tilt forward. It's done nicely, looks just like a Willis. Can't confuse that for anything else, really. It's so little, but so cool looking. You can see the opening. No detail underneath whatsoever, just some pin marks. But it looks nice. Smooth on the top like it should be. Just requires standard body prep. And there's your main body. And I'm sure you could open the trunk, but there's nothing back there, so there's nothing really to open it for. You'd have to build everything on the inside. And there you go. There's no like headliner or anything. Just a couple pin marks inside, but again, they're inside. Who really cares? Here's the main chassis. Very basic, but nice enough detail for a dragster. These are older kits. They've been around a while. But hey, they're giving them new themes and releasing them. That means I like it. Now, there are some clear parts in the kit. You can go with a tinted yellow windshield, so everything looks like you have jaundice. Or you can go with clear. And of course, you can tint those clear parts to your heart's desire. Last but definitely not least are the meats, the tires. It's not Arby's, we got the meats, but it's not, same one. The front tires are the nice skinny tires. And they do have writing on them, but my eyes aren't good enough to read those through the camera or on the outside right now. Not feeling so hot, but if you can read those, let me know what those say. Something sports, that's all I can read. But they do have nice tread, nice design on them. They're printed on both sides. Good looking tires. I always like Round 2 AMT tires. Here's where the rubber meets the road. Check those out. They even continued the Three Stooges theme into the tires. Wise Guy Rubber Company and Purple Stripes. Now, I love that. That has to be my favorite part of the kit aside from the decals. You can also run them black walls if you want. They are marked for a regular company with regular size marks. But come on, you got to paint the car purple. You got to run these slicks on it so you have Curly's Gasser. I just love them. Love all the tires, the pad-printed tires that Round 2 is putting in their kits. So, that's it. That is AM... No, wait a minute. We're not done. Oh, you didn't think you were going to get away with it. What's included in the box? For free? A whoopee cushion. It's a Gasser, a whoopee cushion, the Stooges. Yep. You know I'm going to do it. I've inflated it. This is what's included in the box at no charge. The whoop, whoop, whoop. Curly's Gasser, whoopee cushion. So, it's pretty cool. It's a great kit. It's less than 25 bucks on the market. Includes Stooges theme stuff, including a whoopee cushion. Who wouldn't want to buy this kit? So, in closing, thanks for watching HPI Guys Model Workshop of the AMT 40 Willis Coupe Curly's Gasser.